Yellow Productions presents How to Ride the Subway Trains and Shinkansen in Osaka, Japan. I'm Chris, this is Yellow Productions. I do travel guides that are fun, informative, entertaining. This is part of my series on Osaka, and after watching this video, you'll be an expert on how to ride these trains. At first, they can seem confusing. There's a lot of tracks, there's a lot of trains, there's a lot of people, but after watching this video, you'll be a pro. I'll break this video down into a few different sections. First, we'll start with just things you need to know about the train system in general, then we'll talk about what you need to do to buy tickets, and then we'll talk about riding the train, finding the train, and finally getting off at your destination and then finding the correct exit from the station, because there are many exits. All right, here we go. Okay, let's start by talking about some general things you should know about public transportation in Osaka. The first one you need to know is there are a lot of different train companies. Japan Railways is the major operator, and I'm just up above where I was before in Osaka Station. They operate the major trains throughout Japan, but there's a lot of private train operators as well. So the subway is operated by a different company, there's the Hankyu line, there's other lines operated by different companies. And so if you're trying to buy tickets to each one of those lines and you transfer, it's really expensive. So the first thing you should do is you should get an IC card. We'll talk more about that later in the ticket section. Something else that having all the different companies leads to is stations being named a little differently depending upon the company that operates it. And the stations, they really often aren't just one station. It's usually a conglomeration of like five stations by five different companies that all end up in the same place, again with slightly different names. This station, Osaka Station, that's the JR name of it, but some of the private companies that run in here call it Umeda Station. There's three major stations you'll want to be concerned with when you're taking trains around here. Obviously Osaka slash Umeda Station. The second big station in the city is Namba Station. That one, it has a few different companies, and those stations are disconnected. They're not on top of each other. And then the third major station you'll be concerned about is Shin Osaka, because Shin Osaka is where the Shinkansen, or the bullet train, comes into. So note, if you are taking the bullet train into Osaka, you will not be arriving at this station, Osaka Station. You will be arriving at Shin Osaka Station, which is a different train station altogether. So speaking of all those lines, there's two lines that you'll probably find yourself on quite a bit as a visitor. One of them is the subway Midosuji line. It runs right through the center of the city, and many of the major tourist attractions are on that line. The other line you might find yourself on is the JR Osaka Loop line. That one runs to Osaka Castle, and if you're on some of the outdoor trains like that one, make your way to the first car. It's pretty neat to see the view from the first car, and you can watch the conductors, how they operate it. Okay, so now that you know a little bit about the system, now you're deciding someplace to go, and you are someplace, you need to figure out how to get there. You've probably looked at the route maps, and maybe your mind has been blown. Good news, Google Maps is your friend. Google Maps will do a pretty good job if you put in where you are and where you want to go to give you some pretty reasonable routes. It may not give you all of them, and it may not give you the fastest one, but it'll put together a route that is pretty good to tell you at least what stations to get to. Another option, there's an app and a website called Hyperdia. Another option, something that I like to do if I'm starting at my hotel and I want to go someplace, I will ask the hotel staff, hey, how do you get there? For example, I was going to Osaka and I asked them, hey, how do I get to Osaka Castle? And you'll often get an answer like, well, you could take the JR line to this station, or you could take the subway to this station, or you could take this line to this station, which I'll generally say, well, if you were to go, how would you go? And they might say, well, I'll take the JR line because when I get there, there's a lot more food around the JR line. So there's many options to put together, but kind of know the stations you're going to go to, because if you get to this station and you're just trying to look at the maps, that will be quite difficult.
The best way to buy tickets for public transportation in Osaka is with a reloadable IC card. It's called Ikoka in Osaka. It's compatible with Suica and many of Japan's other IC cards. Simply put, you want to get one of these cards. You can buy them from any one of these vending machines at pretty much any subway and train station. It costs 2,000 yen with a 500 yen deposit. You can reload it as you go. This will make your life so much simpler.
Okay, so let's say you don't take my advice and you want to buy individual tickets. Well, every ticket station will have ticket machines and a map
that shows you how much the fares are from the station. On this map, I'm right here where the red is, and those numbers, that's how much the tickets are in yen to get to the different stations. So you'll see as I back out here, as we get farther away from this station, the ticket prices get more and more expensive. Want to buy one of those tickets? You would come up to this machine, you would push the button that says English, and things would turn to English. You would say, purchase a ticket, and then you would pick the amount of the yen that you saw on the map up there. So let's say we want to go 390, then you would just go ahead and insert your money there, and you would get a little ticket that would come out of this machine. From these machines though, you should really purchase the iCoca card, 2,000 yen, and you'll get one of those IC cards.
The one time you will want to buy tickets is if you're traveling on a reserved seat train. For example, some of the rapid trains like the Haruka to the airport, you can reserve a seat. In that case, you'll want to head to the ticket counter. They typically say tickets, and they'll have a little icon that's green of a reclining seat. While there are vending machines, they're usually green in color, that you can buy reserved seat tickets from, they can be a little confusing, so I'd suggest you head to the manned counter. You'll also need to go to a manned counter if you're buying tickets to the Shinkansen. And if you're buying reserved seat tickets, many trains have a regular class and a green class, which is their equivalent of first class. That'll have an extra surcharge. Okay, so you've got your IC card and you're ready to ride. How do you get in? Well, you find the wicket, one that doesn't have an X, but one that has a green arrow. You find the IC thing, you tap it on, and then it'll tell you how much money you have left on your card. If you are traveling with a JR pass, don't insert it into the ticket gate. Instead, go to the manned ticket lane and show your JR pass. They'll just let you through.
If you are traveling on the Shinkansen, the bullet train, it will have its own special entrance and own special ticket gates. In that case, go to those ticket gates and insert your ticket or tickets into those wickets. You might have multiple tickets for the Shinkansen, one for the base fare, one for the seat, one for the express. In that case, put two or three into the wickets. You'll then pick all of them up out the other side because you'll need to show your tickets on the train as well.
So now that you're through the ticket gate and into the station, you'll need to find the track that your train is going on. They'll typically have signs in the ceiling that tell you what trains and lines are on which tracks. For the subway, it's pretty easy because it's usually just two directions, one line. For the JR stations, it's more complicated. This station, the JR Tennoji station, has 18 tracks. And in the ceiling, take a look at the lines. It'll tell you what lines are on what track and then what direction. For example, here on 17 and 18, Yamatoji line for Shin, Amamiya and JR Namba, local and rapid service. And pay attention to the direction too, because the other direction on the Yamatoji line is on a completely different platform. The JR stations will also typically have a big illuminated signboard that tell you the times and the destinations of most of the close upcoming departures and what tracks they're on. So if you want to avoid walking around the whole station, you could take a look at one of these signboards. If you're riding the subway, one of the nice things is all the stations have letters and numbers, so you can just tell whether you're going in the increasing letters and numbers or the decreasing letters and numbers. Okay, so now that you've made it to your platform, you need to figure out where to wait for your train. Something to pay attention to if you're on the JR lines, there are some cars that are reserved for women only. And if you see women only on the platform, that means if you're not a woman, you shouldn't stand there. These little marks that are along the side, these essentially show you where the door is going to be. And so this is where you would stand to wait for the train. If it's a busy time, there will generally be lots of people here. And here's one where there's a train here. You would essentially wait to the right and to the left of the door. When the train arrives, doors open, everybody kind of stands to the side, lets everybody get out, and then you get on. You'll know the train arriving because there will typically be music of some sort to let you know it's coming. Make sure you stand behind the yellow line so you don't get hit by the train. I want you to keep watching my videos, and if you got hit by the train, you wouldn't be a very good video watcher anymore. I should also mention that when you're waiting for your train, take a look at the times on the signboard. If your train is at 1:15,
and it is 1:13 and there's a train there, chances are that is not your train. There are often many trains that arrive on these tracks just a few minutes apart, so make sure you are getting on the correct train. If you are taking the Shinkansen, your ticket will be for a certain car and a certain seat. And so if that's the case, on the Shinkansen tracks, there will be signs to tell you where that particular car is going to stop. Make sure you wait at the correct car stop, because the Shinkansen is nearly a mile long. I'm slightly exaggerating, but it's a super long train. You won't be able to run to your car in the length of time that the Shinkansen actually stops there. So once you've got on the correct train, if it's not very busy, then just go ahead and grab a seat. They'll be open. Just make sure you don't sit in the priority seats. Those are for elderly, pregnant women, people carrying children, unless you're in one of those categories. If you are, there will be special signs to tell you where those priority seats are. If it's busy and all the seats are taken, then you can stand in the middle around the doors. There's some poles there. If you're standing where the seats are and you're holding the grab bars, then make sure you face the people sitting in the seats. So your belly will be facing their face. Do not stand the other way. You don't want to put your rear end in people's faces. That's the etiquette of riding the trains in Japan. Also, when you're on the train, silence your cell phone and try to be quiet. That's what they do here. When you're riding the trains and subway, you'll find that pretty much everything is announced in Japanese and English. So as long as you're paying attention, you won't have a hard time hearing what your stops are. Also, all the stops have signs in them in English. The subway is extra easy because those ones are lettered and numbered, so it's very easy to count how many stops you have left. I haven't found Osaka to have a lot of digital signage in the subway, but they'll all have maps right above the doors. So just pay attention to roughly how many stations you need to go. You can count them and then get off once your count has reached 5, if that's how many stations you're going. Okay, so you're at your destination station. You've got off the train. Now you need to figure out how to go out. What do you mean, how to go out? Don't you just go out, Chris? Well, these stations in Japan have many different exits. For example, Namba Station has 32 different exits. So if you know your exit, just look for the sign and find it. Otherwise, consult one of these signs at the stations that'll tell you what exit where you want to go. So right now I'm going to Dotonbori, and it says go out exit 14. And then you can look at the map that says you are here, and then exit 14, not really in chronological order, is over here. So now, as I go out, I'm gonna look at the ceiling signs that say where is exit 14. Here's one of those signs. It says exit 1 to 13 is that way, exit 14 to 32 is this way. That's where I'm going. Also, it tells me where the bathrooms are and other lines, maybe if that's where I was going. So then you'll look for the yellow sign in the ceiling that says where the exit is, and it says it's out this wicket to the right. So I get my IC card that I tapped in with, I go to the wicket, I put it over the yellow thing, it opens the gate, and then tells me I have 1935 yen left on my card.
If you go to exit the station and you don't have enough money on your IC card, well, you can use one of these fare adjustment machines. They're at the exits to almost all the stations. They typically have a button for English. You push IC card charge, take your IC card, and you insert it into the slot right here, and then it will come up and it will tell you how much money you have on your card. You can pick how much money you want to add, and then you just go ahead and put your money in the bill slot right here. Up to 10,000 yen, you'll get change back in bills and coins. So don't worry, it won't eat all your money.
And then eventually, you'll find the yellow sign for your exit. If you're lucky, it'll be an escalator. If you're unlucky, it'll be a staircase. Oh, and speaking of luggage, if you are planning to bring luggage with you on Osaka's public transportation, you should bring luggage that you can carry up a staircase, because chances are you will encounter a staircase at least once on your public transit journey. Another great thing about Japanese train stations are coin lockers. If you've got too much stuff that you're carrying with you and you want to leave it for a while, find these coin lockers. They are in every major JR train station and many of the other companies as well. And the way you use it is basically you can press here to get English, and then you can put in your luggage.
and you put in your luggage, you pull down a lever, you put in your IC card, it locks it, and you get charged, and you unlock it when you get back with your IC card. It's pretty fancy, no keys needed. But one note on the lockers, the train stations are really big and there's lots of lockers, so remember which locker you put your stuff in, otherwise you might be wandering around without your luggage for a long time. Last thing I wanted to point out is that while Osaka is not quite as busy as Tokyo, the trains can get busy, particularly during morning and evening rush hours. So if you want to avoid getting squashed onto a train, and I like to avoid that, don't ride between 8 and 9 in the morning, that's the morning rush hour, and then shortly after 5 o'clock, that's when you'll find the trains to be most crowded. Well, that's all there is to it. Super easy. Now you'll be a pro at riding the trains and subway when you come to Osaka. Well, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please click on this yellow ball right here to subscribe. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, links in the description below, or you might enjoy watching one of our other videos up here for more fun, informative, entertaining videos from Japan and beyond. All right, bye-bye.